Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Night Attack. This episode of Night Attack was recorded a scant 24 hours after the election of President-elect Donald Trump. It pursuant to the interests of our audience, we have decreed that for the duration of this episode, not one word will be spoken of politics. We hope you enjoy this episode of Night Attack.
Brian came home from like this Europe trip with like souvenirs.
So I went to Istanbul in Turkey, and I went to a curio shop, and I kind of saw definitely a china set featuring Hitler, and I was like, "You're fucking kidding me!" So I definitely bought some Hitler teacups.
What? What? Somewhere in our house.
Oh, and on that note, that means it has got to be go time for Night Attack. Bringing to the best of the worst of the internet ever since 1776. Hello, beautiful people, live in studio right here in Austin, Texas. I'm Brian Brushwood, joined on a very special occasion by my BFF here in AUS. It's JRY. What is going on, Justin?
Brian, man, I was up late last night.
Yeah, were you?
And then got here first thing in the morning.
You sure did. That was by the way, man, that was a great moment of being able to say like, hey, I think we need to hug each other. I think we just need a bro hug.
There was a point last night during our live stream. It was a long one.
Yeah.
We were watching TV.
Yeah, no, there was something. There was on TV. It was the big matchup.
The big matchup. You can't use the word anymore because they own it, right? So you have to just say like Olympics or Super Bowl.
Oh
right?
Yeah, the big game. We were watching the big game.
We were seeing the big time for everyone to choose.
Sure. We saw the choosening. Recently branded.
We saw you choose.
America, are you ready for the choosening? Do you have your... We can't say the B word. Do you have your allocation tablets? Instead of...
Yeah.
Yeah, your allocation tablets.
The ats.
Your chits.
Do you have your chits?
Bust out your chits for the allocationing.
Don't leave your chits on the floor. Leave them in the... square with a slot on it.
We definitely did some blitz chits.
We did some
last
blitz
night.
And chits and
yeah.
Anyway, so I'm up early and now I'm here. Let's go ahead around the room.
Yeah,
and
we got everyone here. We got MikeTV live here in studio. Hey. By the way, let's get plugs right out of the way because I know that you're blowing up your Twitch right now, right?
Oh yeah. So I've been doing 5 days a week, Monday through Friday. I've been doing like a 4-hour live stream, being playing music and hanging out with people and. It's been awesome. It's been super, super. Which camera am I talking to? This one?
No,
one?
You talk yep. to us. I talk cameras to don't exist. Okay. Yeah. All right. Come on.
We're
what are you doing?
Just well,
no,
out,
because
man.
I've been working on my hypnotoad skills, goddammit.
No, I'll tell you what, man. No, that's a grind. That's a slog. But you're building that community though,
and it's awesome. I mean, it's been so much fun, and it's just been ridiculous. I've given like the regulars command over sound effects, so they get to actually participate. Is this becoming a little bit like Rocky Horror Picture Show slash like a rock show? You know,
because you were talking about you're like I don't know. Once I played my album two or three times, what else will they say?
Yeah. That's
did a push up, ate an egg on it. What else are you gonna do with it?
Yeah. No, but you're discovering that you know, of course, you know the people. There's a reason people go to live performances, even though the album version is better than whatever they're hearing inside the stadium.
Absolutely. Well, in fact, there are people that are like they're like. I actually prefer the you with just your acoustic guitar. So I'm like, well, then right on. I will record some of these songs like this, and I'll push them out to you guys.
Real quick, just so we get this out here, what is the Twitch?
It's MikeTV Live.
MikeTV Live. Yeah. Follows are free. Everybody, I know that we have a lot of our audience is on Twitch. Everybody, if you are not following Mike right now, go ahead and follow him. You were telling us a story of what happened last... How are we going to do this?
Yeah, well, go on.
I mean, because we can't just do this. I mean, like this dancing around.
Wait, are you talking? You want to talk about last night? Yeah. About last night.
About
is
last
my
night.
Favorite.
Oh,
80s
I don't
movie.
Think.
No,
don't
we
think
can't
because
we can't listen. A lot of people. Obviously, this is a very emotional time for everybody, no, right? We wanted to give a sanctuary.
This was.
But we can't just do. We can't just imagine that it's not there.
Okay, we want to discuss issues that happened in the last 24 hours, but we made a solemn promise not to speak a single word about politics. Speak is a very specific word.
Hmm.
It seems to me like we can express all kinds of emotions as long as we sing. All right, the rule is for the remainder of tonight, you can express anything political, but it must be in song.
Yes.
How about that?
Here to keep us honest is our super producer and referee for the evening, Bryce Neshcom Castillo.
Hi,
everybody,
guys.
Let's get
all right, Bryce, here's
cracking
here's
that
the,
whip.
Here's the game plan. We're just going to freeform this. We're not going to try to lead into song, but if you catch us veering
sure.
into politics, you go ahead and you
I'm
going to
give you
Bryce.
I'm going to give you the belt music.
Oh, you, there yeah. you go. Okay, all right. The belt yeah. music's got to be in song. All right. So man, what a wild ride. Hey,
holy crap.
Can we talk about and this is non-political. How fucking rad was it that we had so many viewers last night? That it was a real problem for your friend of mine, Sergeant Muffin.
The sergeant, the good sergeant, had a real problem. Yeah, no. So for those of you who were watching, this is a record, I think, for DiamondClub.tv. We brought in what would be, and we know from being on the opposite side of this.
Yep.
This would be a great crowd for Twit.
Yeah.
What they would attract live, like we attracted last night. It was over 1,000 concurrent viewers.
Yep.
And then we called Dan Carlin. So God knows.
Oh my
God. Once it spread
yeah,
into
that
other
awkward
stuff.
Moment when Dan Carlin says, "What should I tweet out?" And you think, "Well, you can't tweet out anything because it's all slammed. And if you're in, you're in. And that's that."
Also, big shout out to the Ritual Misery podcast that I know we're very, very good about setting up redundant stuff. This is on DiamondClub.tv.
Oh, my
this
God.
This is what we were looking at.
Oh, my God.
The data from last night.
Wow. That's awesome. That is awesome.
We have some MS Paint or clip art things.
Holy cow.
On top
that's
of it.
Amazing.
But yeah, that was at the peak moment as things were coming in. That was before... The results sort of started to make themselves known.
Sorry, what results?
I mean,
tell you what, just give me a slow build.
Okay.
Like you're walking down the street getting ready for a gang fight. I was hanging out with my buddy Justin one night. We was watching the election results come on in. And then all of a sudden, there shined surprising results.
Pennsylvania.
Well, the folks all around this town, they all dug their heels in and said, well, we're going to stick around and watch this to the very end. And
yeah.
Justin and I, we got real drunk on a live stream for thousands of folks watching live.
And all together, we would hum our anthem.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Kool-Aid.
Yeah. No, keep it going. Keep it going. Keep it going.
Oh, yeah.
Then... Brian, well, he got the wine out.
Yeah. It was about this time that some of the folks in the town started hurling insults and looking at Brian saying, this is your fault.
Protest votes made Trump win!
To which Brian said, well, that's ridiculous. I am but one man who made a vote. How can I possibly be responsible for a 6 million shortfall? And they said, shut up! This is your fault.
Is that the I started to say. Oh, yeah!
Well, and as those tears fell, we all sung our anthem. Oh, yeah!
Well, we had thousands of people.
No, music's over.
Oh, sorry. Never mind. All right.
No. This is an opera.
It's now an opera. Fuck off.
Oh, yeah. Or not. It's fine. Are we going to do the whole thing?
I mean, we got to tell
the
whole
story. Hour by hour opera?
That's what it's like. Yeah. Everything is sung. The entire show is just sung.
Well, at that point, we noticed that not all of Broward County had been counted, and hope started to fade.
We sang our anthem one more time.
Oh, yeah.
It was a weird night.
It was.
Unlike tonight.
Getting personally blamed for the presidency was a weird thing. Everyone's just like, great job, fucko. They all turned into Stan Lees.
Yeah. Oh. No, there was definitely, as alluded to, actually, here, let's change it to this. Oh. Okay, here we go. Let's change it to this. Yeah. Bryce, now you are the ref that whenever there is something that you want made into song,
okay,
then flag that. Because right. I don't think we're going to go in and out. We can't do the whole entire episode.
Let's talk about the best part of last night. Best part of last night was when we cast a summoning spell and we said, Mem Sahib, Rabbi has memo, and all of a sudden Dan Carlin appeared.
Wait, how did that spell go again?
Mem Sahib, Rabbi has memo.
Can we get something like dark and like demonic?
Sure. All right, so this is how the summoning spell went.
Wait, what's it like metal style dark? Yeah.
Like.
Wait,
Man, this is gonna be a great rock.
Yeah. Album. Oh man, I'm feeling that.
Here we go.
Yeah. Come, witness the summoning spell.
Sahib, Rabbi has memo. He's a palindrome I saw on The Simpsons once. I hope Dan Carlin will appear upon our stream. What's that? Ah, it's Skype.
What you don't know about Thomas Jefferson.
Oh, Dan Carlin, you're here. You're one of us.
The Roman Empire is a very complicated thing.
Oh, Dan, it sounds like you've been drinking too.
I don't see Trump winning. This proves to be ironic later in the evening.
Oh, this is the best 40 minutes we've ever had on our stream. Thank you, Mr. Carlin.
I'm about to go away if you don't cast the summoning spell again.
Oh, I didn't. I forgot the palindrome.
Just make it up, fuck off.
Oh, Mem Sahib, Rabbi has memo.
Okay, I'm back.
Anyway, thanks. Wait, why are you back? I think because
you cast the... Sorry, my time's up, y'all. Tip your waitress. I'm Dan Carlin.
So long, Dan Carlin. So it was great. We had a great 40 minutes with Dan Carlin.
Hey, listen, to be fair, how much more are we going to go with the summoning spell, right?
Y'all can go and y'all
summoning
y'all
spell's a 2-minute stinger. All right, so Dan Carlin came on. He was fantastic. What you pointed out also is, like, I'm not as familiar with Dan Carlin as you are.
Yeah.
But A, he doesn't really do a lot outside of the stuff that he does.
No, you can catch him on, like, Joe Rogan's thing occasionally, but that's about it.
Like, that's the only thing.
It's a history thing? Is that
hardcore history. Yeah. He does hardcore history, and then he also does hardcore history. He is such a perfectionist that he only makes these, like, you know, 3 to 6 hour masterpieces 2 or 3 times a year.
Huh.
And the show is always late perpetually. But he also does Dan Carlin Common Sense, which is just these little vignettes where he talks about, you know, his what he calls alien point of view. But the...
No, getting on was fantastic.
Where did that come into your head? Where, like, what was the initial ingredients of you, like, because you started working the phones, and Carlin was the one that we got on, but you wound up just hitting up the phone tree of every interesting person that we could have on, especially as the election got more interesting.
Yeah, well, it occurred to me, like, I don't know why I'm such an idiot, where I'm like, I'm friends with people, and I should ask if they want to be on my friend show, you know? And then, and so I was just like, well, you know, let me go for it. I think, to be honest, I saw him live tweeting the election results coming in. I think he showed up on Twitter, and I was like, oh, man, wouldn't it be great if we got Dan Carlin on? And then I was like, some voice in my head was like, Brian, that's possible. What? How's that possible, voice? He's like, I don't know.
No, you're pandering. You're pandering. Please ignore his pandering. he just wants to do a thing where he does both voices.
I mean, it wasn't so
voices.
Interesting a conversation that it should be made into a song, but... and then I just reached out to him, and he was hilarious, though. Like, after we hung up, I texted him. I hope I'm not talking out of school. I don't think I am. But I wrote, holy shit, man, is this really happening? As the tide was turning and it looked like Trump was going to win. He goes, yeah. Sure seems to be. And I was like, holy fucking shit. And then I was like, it doesn't matter. I wrote, I need something to hold on to here. And he writes, a Jack Daniels bottle.
Awesome.
No, it was crazy.
He was
super
great.
Cool guy.
You can actually get all that in the politics feed. I recorded that as soon as we started talking to him. So you can find all of that.
Yeah,
there.
politics.com, and it's the thing right there. How does it start? You had enough time to do a nice big, you know, robust introduction.
Let's put that in the budget, and I'll. And
no, hey, it's literally
you
want to
approve it. Yeah, it's literally Brian right at the top.
Yeah.
Or BonerWars.com is how you can also
BonerWars.com is where you can get to politics.
Can you believe this?
BonerWars?
BonerWars.com.
That's awesome.
Go to my website, BonerWars.com. It's fueled by enhancement pills. They made me 10 feet tall. Everybody knows I'm 10 feet tall.
Yeah, no, I forgot who got that for me, but I was making a joke about BonerWars.com, and boom, all of a sudden, there it goes. It links to... Politics.com. Yeah.
So somebody in the chat is aghast that I don't remember when you said that. Test says, Brian, you were on the show when Justin said that. Look, man.
I said what?
That BonerWars.com goes to politics.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
It was during the Kanata thing. Because I remember at the end of it, I texted Justin because I couldn't believe
it.
Oh, no,
we had it before that.
But I remember... Yeah. Like, that's when Brian went.
When I told,
it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But
I thought what you were talking about, what I had said, was that right now, if you use offer code election on thecontender.us, you can get anything in the store with free shipping. I thought that was what I thought you were referring to. Yeah.
Well, no, I'm sorry. What is the contender?
It's the game of presidential debate where, you know, you and your friends can, maybe it's not the best time to plug a game that makes you relive a political season today, but no, go ahead and check it out. Thecontender.us, the election is the offer code.
What was the offer code you ended up the night with as things got increasingly sideways?
All right, just so everybody understands, if you did not watch the live coverage, shit breaks down at a certain point, right? Like, Brian starts getting into his foxhole because he feels under siege by all of the internet. Bonnie's crying.
Literally crying.
Like, loudly. For
those of you who are not aware,
I'm so sorry,
part
everybody.
Of Politics is I have Onesie Wednesday. So I've been buying these onesies, and I'd wear a onesie because I think it'd be funny that you have somebody giving fairly serious or insightful political commentary while wearing a onesie. It came from me at the Republican National Convention when I was interviewing people as Charmander.
Right.
Yeah.
So I thought the big fun way to like call the election would be to have two onesies, a donkey onesie symbolizing the Democrats and the elephant onesie symbolizing the Republicans. Now, that's all a fun idea. It's not as fun when, you know, you do the show throughout the beginning and everything, everyone's having a good time. We're all professional. We're all like finding like, oh, well, if you look county by county, there's some really interesting results. Smash cut. Brian has a bottle of wine that he's just like sucking off the side of. And he's just like, I don't know why people think I'm the problem. I think they're the problem. Bonnie's crying. And I'm picking up my elephant ones. Again, a grown 33-year-old man picking up an elephant onesie. And because everybody's so invested, they're just screaming all caps in the chat room, don't do it. Don't put it on. Wait for Luzerne County. Wait for Luzerne County. They're not all counted in Allegheny. You can't do it yet.
Oh.
What? Oh,
I
was in.
I like to think about that turn, the turn where it went from, you know, friendly fun into like a Mountain Goat song.
Okay,
yeah,
we want to go.
Yeah, people don't know you did an amazing job.
All right, here we go.
Let me set it up. I'm going to toss it to you.
Okay.
People say things got a little bit nutty back in 2016. But I say, you ain't heard nothing till you heard the tale of Allegheny County. My buddy Justin was right there.
One man and a microphone. An elephant onesie, signifying dreams shattered, hope dashed in his trunk, lowered for Allegheny County, why is Michigan going to? I thought that would definitely be blue. Michigan. Allegheny County. Michigan.
Well, it ain't no surprise to most of you that Allegheny too fell. But not before this man was faced with a choice. See, he'd made a promise to his citizens, and it was time to keep it.
Why is Broward not in yet? They said this should be over by 8. But it ain't.
No, it ain't.
No, it ain't.
No, it isn't.
No, it ain't.
No, it ain't.
No, it ain't.
No, it ain't.
Lick Brian's taint.
Elephant onesie.
Elephant onesie, oh.
And they sang their song.
Lick Brian's taint.
Oh.
Elephant onesie.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. That was amazing.
Oh.
Bonnie, you're going to have to get the shop back to suck up all that sploosh. That shit was hot.
Adorable, you guys.
Yeah, so like they didn't want to admit it was over, huh?
Well, I mean, I think people get invested, right? I mean, obviously, listen, I came here today on the BART, and listen, the public transit system in California, we're not doing another song. The public transit system in California is not exactly like a party. Right,
oh, but normally, I beg your pardon. The one time I took it with you, it turned into a party. When
I mean, like Friday, Saturday nights, there's street performers.
Dude, it was
and
amazing.
Stuff like that.
Dudes came in, busted out a jam box, started breakdancing. It was incredible.
But in general, like on the morning commute, you're not going to see a lot of crazy stuff, right? But there's usually chatter. Today, like it was hollowed out. It was like a bomb went off.
9/12, right?
It was just everybody. Yeah, they were covered in white ash. All right.
9/12.
What would you say? Be about white supremacy.
What?
Yeah.
What?
Wait a minute.
I don't know who said that.
it was crazy.
Of people on the
stop.
No.
So anyway,
there's a special kind of joke, and it's the joke where you say specifically, "Don't bring this up on the show."
Yeah. Sorry.
Sorry. With 6 million people. Okay, so Jesus. That's the joke. We already said the joke.
It was very quiet. Yeah, yeah. So it was quiet on the train, huh? It was
very quiet on the train. And listen, there's a lot of people today that are very sad. They're angry today. You know, they're out there. There's protests in New York and San Francisco and everything.
Actually,
Austin.
Not my president.
It's already like a huge thing. And I think in that moment, that was when it became real.
Okay.
It just became real with a 33-year-old bearded man putting on a child's onesie.
Yeah.
For me, can I just do a little weird interjection? Every single time there's like rioting in the street, I just think like somebody's fucking up their civilization game. I'm like, oh shit! Like you need to send more resources.
Somebody's switching to fascism.
Yeah.
They're getting
like, what
ready
are you doing? I know. No, I'm like, oh no, shit, that's terrible.
Like everyone's going to go protest in Austin today, and it's like, oh, it's a turkey leg. I don't know, maybe now I'm not so upset.
We're like, oh, look, there's another unit here.
I see Central Market is just like, okay, we got to pump out these turkey legs.
Yeah, that's right. No, they're not children's onesies, Waffleophagus. They are adult onesies.
So,
I mean, where do we even go from here? You had a funny situation happen to you. Not funny. I mean, like you had a situation that apparently led you to
version of how it went.
Oh, okay.
You might need to.
Here, okay. How about this? Hold on. Let's see.
Yeah, here we go. Now, let me tell you.
You're just gonna do the.
I gotta set him up.
He's got it.
Here we go.
Well, I was streaming like a streamer every day, and I was playing, and my fans they were watching away, and I had one guy, and he was you know, just keeping us updated on what was going on in the election.
The news!
And it was funny, and it was fun. We had people there, and they were representing different groups. And then eventually things just started getting a little bit... Wait a minute, is Donald Trump? Is the guy from behind coming up? Is the dark horse rising? The dark horse is rising.
Dark horse is rising.
The dark horse is rising.
Dark horse is rising.
The dark horse is rising. The dark horse is rising. So we were like, "Hey, this is fun and this is hilarious." But don't worry, because this boy was from Denmark, so he didn't understand how the American elections work. So we were like, "Hey, man, it's okay that Donald Trump took Missouri. Like, we expect that." But then all of a sudden we hear that Florida's in play. And wait a minute, is Michigan in play? How can that be? Dark horse is rising.
Fire is rising.
The dark horse is rising. Over the horizon.
Dark horse is rising.
Came a big orange balloon.
Coupons for horizon.
Red map.
So for you. yeah, man. So for you, like, there was some point where all of a sudden the concert was like, So anyway, I gotta go pee.
Yeah.
Shut down the stream.
So there's a moment where I'm like, okay, guys, I can't do this anymore. I have to go see what's going on, because it sounds like the thing that was in the bag has suddenly escaped and is clawing the faces of people across
the decidedly no longer in the bag. There used to be a bag, and now it's gone.
And it's,
So as things got later, like at some point it was fascinating because, I mean, it was certainly a surprise to, I think, everyone, right? But certainly
everybody in the media, all the pollsters, and according to the leaks that were coming out early in the night, both campaigns.
Both campaigns,
the Clinton campaign was saying, hey, we're feeling really good about Florida. crash in Ron Howard narration. They were not sure about Florida.
Have you seen today all of the magazines that got delivered?
Oh, yes.
With all the, like, Madam President.
Yeah, I saw that. That's hilarious.
About that dough.
What?
And then meanwhile, the Trump campaign was saying, hey, listen, we think we need a miracle to win. And it came out further that the big, gigantic data operation that the Republicans built after Mitt Romney lost showed a bunch of reporters what their map was, and their optimistic map was 230 electoral votes for Donald Trump.
Wow.
Like, that was them like, all right, when we adjust all the stats to 10, this is what we can get to. So, anyway, y'all, see you in 2020. Like, they thought it was done, and as it turned out, it was obviously not done.
Do you think that at some point in time they went to Trump and they're like, we think you got it. Do you think he was like, wait, what?
I guarantee you.
There's no way.
There was a moment of
silence. Yeah. He's like, do I really want this job? Wait, can I back? Like, is there a pop?
I will guarantee you, he looked right up at his two chief advisors, Kellyanne Conway and Steve Bannon, and said,
I told you.
Fuck, I got to go to patreon.com/nightattack. Because before I become president, you know, like, I got to make sure.
I got to get that donation in.
Exactly.
I have to join one of the 1,547 fabulous patrons that keep us loud, live, and independent over at Night Attack, man. Hey, by the way, a lot of people listening right now have a donation, and you've been doing it for a while. Maybe you got in, dipped a toe in the water at 10 cents. Now's a pretty good time to evaluate. Like, have you ever noticed at the end of the month, have you ever once gone like, that $2 I spent on those jackholes?
Yeah, probably not.
Probably not.
Probably not. So if you went up a buck...
I mean, to a buck. Just a buck. Just a buck.
Just a buck.
A buck an episode, right?
A buck an ep.
And guess what?
A buck an ep.
You know what? You know what you get? You know what you get for a buck?
What do you get for a buck, Brian?
You get your very own
RSS
feed.
Ladies and gentlemen. Leading into this bit.
you get your very own RSS feed. That means you get to double the time that you spend with us. Because a lot of people, they're doing work. They want to feel like they're hanging out with their buddies. You're only getting half the show if you listen to the Freezies. You get your own RSS feed. We're going to hang out with you for the pre-show, the actual show, and the after show.
So just to make it clear, the use case, you can just have the podcast feed the way that you would normally have the podcast feed, right?
Yep.
Except this time you get... triple the show with the after show and the pre-show.
Hells to the yes, man. It's amazing.
All right. Hold on.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the Night Attack new Patreon name chant corner hour.
This is going to be a very special one because it's going to have musical accompaniment.
Oh.
I'll tell you what, can we...
Because, by the way, this is what happens. If you go up a buck, Brian gets an alert.
I get an email.
And so now you put yourself in the running for the Patreon name chant jingle.
Wait. Excuse me.
Night Attack new patron name chant corner hour.
So, I'm sorry. Yeah. Fuck me, right? All right, go ahead, Bonnie.
Does that mean if you go from zero to a buck, does that mean
you're in? Same thing. Yeah.
As long as you're over a dollar.
I'll tell you what. I got a great name. And this is a great patron because he upped his pledge from $3 an episode to $4 an episode.
Oh.
He's probably on a treadmill right now thinking, oh, damn, they're not talking about me,
are they?
Why are
all these listeners on treadmills?
They're all on treadmill.
They're all running.
We have the fittest.
No.
We have
He's in the middle of joggling three balls as he runs.
Jogging and juggling.
I disagree. I think he's commuting to, or she, I'm going to say.
Oh!
That's right.
Madam Patron.
She's on her commute in a, you know, electric car, so she can hear because there's not all the noise from all the like exhaust and everything.
Sure.
So
yeah.
I hate that exhaust noise also, in like Dodge Avenger.
Also her
Exactly. Exhaust.
Also her name is Zachary Durst.
Zachary Durst.
I'll tell you what, can we get a jauntier tune? I mean real jaunty. Real jaunty. I'm saying downright whimsical.
Exactly. Let's hear some sounds from the land that used to make presidents. Is that too real? Too soon? Too soon?
All right, here we go.
Yeah, it was like,
too soon?
I love this.
Here we go.
Okay, so what are we looking for?
We're going to tell the legend of Zachary Durst. You ready?
Okay. Good luck.
A and we'll just hand it off, all right?
Okay. Well.
That's my bit. No. All right, ready? Zachary Durst. He ain't the worst. Now, I can think of at least one other person who's worse.
Zachary Durst. He ain't the worst. I can think of Hitler. Who's worse?
I got a thirst for Zachary Durst. Oh, Zachary. Woohoo!
Zachary Durst. He is my the first when I think of all the awesome people.
Zachary Durst.
Zachary Durst.
Zachary Durst.
Zachary Durst.
Zachary, 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 Zachary Durst.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Patreon.com/nightattack.
Oh my god!
This is my favorite. I love this. So much fun.
Zach is. Can I call him Zach?
Yeah, you can. Well, yeah, call him. As long as you call it into the microphone.
You can call him the D-bomb.
Zach is so happy right now.
Yeah,
we love you, Zach.
I like to imagine, because I like your idea of him on the treadmill. Except I imagine him in like one of those like athlete performance centers where he's got like the mask on and like all the heart monitors, and then he hears that and then like
he starts going double fast
and then like he comes off and he's like yeah, that one felt pretty good, and there's like the guy who's there's like ashen face and he's like, that's the fastest anyone's ever run.
See, I like,
you just broke the record, Zachary.
I would like to think Zachary's in the middle of taking a shit listening to a podcast.
Same thing.
Yeah. And he's having his mind blown by this song composed for him. But then meanwhile, smash cut to person on the next stall over, and you just hear, hee-hee-hee.
Yeah. Exactly. And then he takes off the mask, and an ashen-faced scientist comes out and says, that's the best shit anyone's ever made. Zachary Durst. Zachary, 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 Zachary Durst.
He ain't the worst.
Oh.
Good shit. Good
shit. It's a record.
Hey, so,
So anyway, Trump won.
Yeah, but okay, but at the end of the night, like, I don't know.
Do we want to get into the big controversy?
I guess, because to be honest, I don't remember much of the end of the night.
Controversy?
Well, we can explain it.
All right. Yeah. As things went on, Brian, again, I wanted to describe Brian here. Neshkam, go to your shot, because that's where Brian was.
Sure, yeah. Sure.
Yeah. Lean back. Imagine that you're
drunker.
Yeah, drunker.
In fact, actually, the actual empty bottle's right there. Grab the empty bottle. Hand that over.
Actually, no. Switch.
I'm gonna do my impression of Brian.
Okay. All right, there we go. So right now, for the audio listeners, Justin is assuming the mantle. He's taking over the role. Sitting in the studio.
Okay, so he's in the studio.
And by the way, keep in mind, we are at our all-time highest live viewer count. People are tuning in just to see what all the buzz is about.
So here's the key here is that Brian is leaning back way farther than he should because he is just taking everything in.
And by
that chair goes so far back.
And keep in mind, I am watching my Twitter feed just explode with fingers like directly accusing me personally. Brian Brishwood, you personally dashed my hopes and dreams for not voting the way I wanted you to vote.
You did, Brian. You did.
So Brian, at this point, is drinking this wine
straight from the bottle.
Straight from the bottle. But he's also like not like It's not like normally you would grip the larger part of the bottle,
near the
right?
bottom.
You drink it like that. He's got that like
I got like two fingers up top.
That's
called the wino. The wino.
It's kind of as if he was trying to decide like you know that they do on like baseballs where each person like grabs one hand and then you put the hand on top.
Yeah.
That's like Brian is right up there at the top. He's way choked up and he's just like. You just hear these big exhales, I assume, as the retweets are coming in. And he's like there's a fire that burns in him, and he just drowns it by drinking wine like from the side of his mouth. Just like...
Because I want to be able to read the nasty tweets coming in as I'm drinking.
Yeah, by the way, right now, Katie's asking Bonnie if that's true. Bonnie could not tell us. She was bawling her eyes out.
Yeah, Bonnie couldn't see through all her tears.
I would know. There is, you know, a waterfall happening. Ocean.
So there comes a point.
Clawing its way out of my eyes.
There comes a point wherein Brian is now engaging with the people that are
so
tweeting him.
Responding to the
on cam, right?
While the stream was up.
While the stream is going.
Oh, boy.
And his reaction is, it's a good thing. It's a good thing. It's a good thing.
It's engagement.
It's a good thing. No, it's a good thing. No. The election. The election is a good thing. It's a good thing. It's a good thing. I don't know why everybody's like apparently all of Twitter is yelling at me. I am the only one being yelled at. Everyone's taking it out on me, Brian Brushwood, and it's a great thing. It's a great thing.
Can you real quick sing the ballad of Brian's dilemma?
The ballad of Brian's. Brushwood, he was not. Wait, let me get a progression record. Because I don't know the thing about this well.
He's got a ukulele, and I don't think it's his daily driver.
He's not primarily.
Well, here, I'll tell you what. If you want to switch back to guitar, because
Justin, you can emote.
There's one big thing when Brian describes why this is a good thing.
Well, it could be a good thing. All right, we're gonna reshuffle. We're getting ready to do the play. Zachary Durst. He's not the worst.
I think he's the burst.
He's about to burst.
Swag.
He's about to blurst.
Burst. This side.
Swag.
So the ballad of Wino Brushwood.
Specifically, and listen, this is not a bad argument. Let me just say this.
Yeah.
But Brian leans back. He finds a catchphrase.
Yeah. By the way, just to clarify, for those of you who don't know, I'm fairly staunchly third party.
Yes.
I'm not a fan of the disproportionate amount of power that the presidency continues to get over the years, and so it occurs to me that if there's ever going to be a rebalancing of power, it would occur when a out of left field administration like the Trump administration were to come. So that might be a silver lining to what other people find to be a very dark cloud.
Because otherwise, people believe that the president is what?
Oh! I mean, look, the office of the presidency was originally meant to be an administrative role, an executive officer to
and
lead
not,
the chief bureaucrat, and bureaucrat
not,
in chief.
And not a what?
And not, we do not elect... God kings!
God king!
Who are all powerful ministers of darkness from their fortress, casting bolts and assassinations from their drone-filled hands. God kings!
Bow
listening
me.
To your phone calls, passing judgment from upon high. God King, he determines who gets health care.
The God King,
he decides who, what,
the
where,
God King.
Why, ooh, hair, ooh, he dictates hair.
The God King,
the God King
declares
the God King.
Ooh. without Congress.
God declares king. More.
Ooh,
the God King.
God King.
The God King.
He rules from above. Not below.
The and God he King. Sings his anthem.
The God King.
Oh, oh, oh yeah.
Hey, Kool-Aid!
I think this is the most amazing show.
Yo, for real though, fuck Hamilton.
Yeah.
Fuck Lin-Manuel hey, Miranda.
Hey,
fuck Hamilton.
Your time is over, Lin-Manuel! We're taking this shit to the Great White Way.
God King.
God King.
Coming that's, to Broadway.
I think.
Tomorrow.
I think that might actually be a hit. I think we need to record that song. Like, God yeah. King, right? I really do. I think yeah. that's. A, I think
tomorrow
that's.
We record.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Wait, what do we need? We already just did. Fucking print it.
Money in the bank, girl.
He ain't jumping out of a plane, man. We already got the gold. Paying it out. Put it out to the people. This wow. was a little, it proved controversial, would you say?
Well, and I don't understand what's controversial about it. I think it's very, because
Brian?
either Brian. You're a fan.
Right message, wrong time.
Yes, correct. Right message, wrong time.
You just hit the falsetto. That tells me it's controversial.
Oh, is that the tell? Is that when you know?
I don't know why it'd be controversial.
Is that when Brian doesn't want to get pinned down, so he just goes to a higher register? He's just running away from the point.
You can't catch me. I'm up here.
And this is what it sounds like when the doves cry.
But yeah, I mean, I think the issue was in the chat room that a lot of people were very much either very happy, right?
Yeah.
Or very sad.
So sad that they didn't want to hear about silver linings.
or just anything that wasn't earth-shattering excitement or earth-shattering misery.
Right. No, there was no place last night for the nuanced middle of the road position.
Well, especially one where it's like 20,000 hey, foot. I'm sorry, folks. Like, I don't know why y'all are freaking out. Like, I have this great point about God Kings.
it's like I attended a football game and was cheering for whether or not the ball finished the game on a line or not.
Exactly.
I'm like, yeah. That's what the game's really about, guys. It landed right on that line.
No, I had
pretty good line.
I had to make this was like a thing in my life that I had to realize when everywhere I was talking about gay marriage, right?
Yeah.
Because I was always of the opinion
like
and
government
still am,
should not be involved in that, the marriage
no,
business.
I was like, it's like, okay, well, so gay marriage versus civil unions. This is back in the day. This is like Bush, era. I was like, no, civil unions are great. You should take them, and then straight people should get civil unions and sue to get civil unions, because that's better than having the name marriage tied up. It's like, this is the perfect of all worlds. Everybody, like, you can still get married somewhere, but let's just make civil unions a thing. And it was at this point where I was talking to gay people about this that their eyes just glassed over with
like,
rage.
Jesus Christ,
and they're
what
like,
are you saying?
Like, why are you trying to sell us on the smaller water fountain? Like I don't care. Hey, straight guys, stop trying to sell us on separate but equal. And I'm like, no, but I want your equal. And they're like, fuck you, idiot. And I started to realize that, listen, it can make sense in my head.
Sure, sure.
It's just not the right thing to say at that moment.
Yeah, agreed.
Right? Maybe at some point 50 years down the road when and now the gay marriage has been a thing for a long time and is federally recognized by way of the Supreme Court, we can have a fun little logical discussion of whether or not back in the day it would have been a better path, right? In the moment when the emotions are on the line, I had to learn the lesson that I'm sure a lot of people would wish that people would learn today on Twitter, which is maybe shut the fuck up.
Yeah.
Which I did not learn today on Twitter as I talked constantly. But in general, it is a wise lesson to shut the fuck up.
That's one of those, like, as I got into libertarianism, there's a... You know, what? All of a sudden, there's all these fringe things that everything taken to its extreme is crazy. I have a couple of friends who would troll Austin Cable Access shows. This is back when Alex Jones was doing Austin Cable Access. And so they had some guys doing...
Yeah, yeah.
they had some guys doing, they were libertarians, and one of the points, I guess, take it to its logical extreme, the idea that, you know, humans have rights, but animals do not. That's why mm-hmm. we eat animals mm-hmm. and so on. But he calls him, he's, and the guy says, he's, and you know who this is, you know this person, Bonnie. But he calls in, he goes like, hey, y'all saying that, and you know, it's an affectation, the East Texas accent. He's like, y'all saying that the animals is property, huh? And he's like, yeah, yeah, they are. He's like, so you're fine with bestiality? Bestiality? You can have bestiality. You can have beast foot. He's like, well, yeah, you know, the, you know, animal is not an intelligent being. He can't really make a distinction. You know, we're able to kill them and eat them. You know, why not rub your dick on them or whatever? And he goes, what if the animal's smarter than you? And he's like, yeah. I mean, he goes, what? He goes, like a dolphin. Oh, yeah. And he drags them into this philosophical argument about whether or not you can have bestiality with a dolphin.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah, that's great. That's great. So what was the consensus?
You know what? Strangely, they didn't reach an accord.
That led to Trump winning Texas last night. Yeah. That's the funny thing, is everybody, Hillary was going to win, and then like all the Hillary voters were like, fuck, can I get it in the blowhole? Or like, you know, like, is the bottlenose going to go up?
I mean, Jesus,
like,
but,
you
know, like, teeth are a problem already with humans.
Geez.
I can't even imagine.
Oh, God,
dolphins,
I want to fuck this dolphin.
Are smarter than America.
I'm going. Hold on. I'm sorry. Somebody just stepped into the spotlight. All right, here we go. I want to hear the story about the first dolphin president.
Dolphins.
Wait for it to come here.
Okay. Oh, I don't know anything about music. Obviously.
Well, we're going to figure it out right now.
All right, you got to give me hand signals. Dolphins are smarter than America. And they voted too. You didn't know because you weren't on the beach last night. They cast their shells and they weren't with you. Because dolphins are smarter than America. But they love you.
Dolphins, oh, they love you.
Rap interlude.
Doon, daka, doon, daka.
Dolphins. I don't know. What you mean?
Dolphins love you. Dolphins are smarter than you.
Zachary Durst.
But dolphins are smarter than America.
Because dolphins are smarter than America.
Pretty good.
I think that's got to be a contender.
I feel like I've learned a lot tonight.
That's going to be a contender for the title of the show. I do have to say. Dolphins are smarter than America.
I mean, I'll tell you what. It might be a contender at
thecontender.us.
Free shipping if you use offer code election.
By the way, we should.
Very close to getting out of debt. Very close to getting out of debt.
You should definitely. You should definitely cut to the chase on what was the promo code you introduced at the end of the evening last night?
So shit's getting really barely
like,
loose.
All of a sudden you realize like, oh man, this is really a sideways election, and I'm really only doing this live stream because I need to sell a lot of these contender units.
Oh, I think at that point it kind of became a running joke of me like segueing into, especially as shit got serious, I would keep going back to the contender plug and everything, and then at some point. It became very clear that Hillary Clinton was either in very serious trouble or, as it turned out, was going to lose. And so I decided to put out on the official contender Twitter, which is not like a place where I make jokes. Like, I make jokes at Justin R. Young on Twitter. Contender.us in general is just the standard corporate, like, you know, hey, people are playing the game. Hooray. Like, we have a new sale. Hooray. I decided to put this tweet up.
Clinton supporters use offer code I want to die for free shipping. Deepcontender.us.
31 retweets.
72 likes. Oh, that's awesome.
That's great. And actually. Oh.
What kind of says it is that it's not a, it's like Twitter didn't see it as a link.
What I can actually tell you how many people used it.
Oh yeah, dude.
11 people got free shipping with offer code I want to die.
Well played,
yeah,
sir.
They're like I've got a little ring roll. I've got the little rack roll to your joke.
Yeah.
There you go. There we go.
I want to die. Still active, by the way. So
oh,
if you're
good.
Although I don't know, outside of the context of the nerve-wracking election, it might take on a darker tone.
So I guess we talked about last night. What was it like the morning after for you? Well, outside of the very quiet BART ride.
Really
was it quiet on the plane?
Well, so here's a funny moment. I make, and this bleeds into the idea of just like learning how to shut up, right?
Yep.
I'm reading Twitter and everything. I have Wi-Fi on the plane. And I start to read. Has anybody else noticed that today there's a lot of threads on Twitter? Have you seen these? Like people like RT, and it's just thread, and it's somebody going on like a 9
sure.
tweet kind of thing, but
yeah,
it just lets you know that you need to read a bunch, right? And so I'm reading a lot of these, and a lot of them are very, very interesting, and they're great, and they show a tremendous perspective, right? And one of them that I very much took to heart was, again, hey, you want to know what? Maybe now is not the time for everybody's point of view. You know, there's a lot of people in pain. Let them be in pain. Maybe later in the week, next week, forever. We can all have these conversations with intricate, like, hey, you want to know what? This is what you should do, and this is why you should be happy, and this is why you should be sad. Let's let the nation in an election that went on a year and a half
sure.
get one day of just yelling and screaming and you know, getting it all out. And I was about to respond, because the one thread I was reading was like, hey, look, and this is, I'm sure this is going to rankle some people in the chat room, but it was kind of a check your privilege argument where it's like, hey, if you think everything's going to be fine, look around yourself and realize whether or not everything was going to be fine no matter what. And then realize that there are other people for whom do not have, if you don't have that skin in the game, that they might not think the same way.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You've got a parent that's
and so I'm about to respond, and like I'm thinking, and like I very much respect the point, and I want to add to it, and I want to write my own tweet thread, and it's at that
you
point.
You reach forward, and you see how white your hands are.
So there's that, right? Pull out further. I see the wine bottle come down as it refills at 2 PM, my wine glass.
On an airplane.
While
were you in business? Were you in first class?
While I continue to eat my burrito that was served to me in my gigantic comfy chair because I am indeed in first class.
Ooh, white privilege.
Yeah! Well, let me tell you something. I was sitting in first class.
Oh, damn.
Yeah. Sitting around on my big old ass.
Woo! In first class.
What color was my ass?
White.
Let me pull my pants down.
Was it green? It's blue.
Give you a glance.
White ass.
White ass.
White ass privilege.
White ass.
White ass.
White ass privilege.
That's white class.
White ass privilege.
Hey, stewardess, put a little more wine in my glass.
White ass
privilege.
Because I got a tweet storm. I gotta type fast.
White-ass privilege.
I'm on my way to Texas. Yeah.
White-ass privilege.
Cause I got podcasts to do. I got a white-ass.
White-ass. White-ass privilege.
Oh. White-ass privilege.
White-ass.
White-ass privilege.
Whoa.
White-ass privilege.
So white. Oh.
Yeah.
It was too
$200 to change. Yeah. And a $200 change fee. Yeah. I did it on a credit card. On my new iPhone. White ass privilege. So I didn't tweet. I decided that I needed to not tweet. I didn't tweet at all. So that was just going through my mind. I decided to not tweet.
That's so strange. That's so strange that you would come back.
I had that idea. That was what was going through my head.
So like
and then I decided to not do it.
Like we're just assuming everybody understands irony, right? We understand. Like
oh, that at some point it'll bite me in the ass that I was singing a song about white ass privilege.
Especially because you're not white.
Oh yeah, no, I'm Mexican. As far as you know.
Ha ha! Da 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 da.
Wong, 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 Wong. Wong. Man, and that pretty much brings us here. Brian, is there any final final
can
thing?
I just
any
say,
final tale to tell?
The last 90 minutes have been like the most healing shit I've ever experienced.
Yes.
This has got to be like a therapy. Yes. That people could do. This is amazing.
I mean, literally. How about we do this? Let's go ahead and get to Diamond Time. Of course.
Yeah. Diamond Time, of course, is your chance to shout out your projects in the Diamond Club community. If you head on over to diamondclub.reddit.com, you'll see a sticky post right up top, and you can submit your project. The top three of them we shout out right here live on the show. It looks like we only have two. Starting with, looks like.
We have more than two. You may want to refresh.
Oh, got it. Drugnor.
Yeah, hey, he or she says, hey, folks, first time, long time here, asking for a huge favor from the Diamond Group at all. My wife has just published her first book, and we need some help spreading the word. YOLO420.com/help-the-book-swag. The title is
Ashleisha.
It's an action thriller with sci-fi elements that's also LGBTQA-friendly. To the nth degree, as well as featuring POC throughout. I'm a bit biased, but it's a fantastic read, and I've done so about 8 times now. So if you know anyone looking for a great read that features POC gay heroes kicking all kinds of ass, give it a try. Hell yeah, man.
Right
so
on,
go
man.
Ahead and check that out. That is YOLO420.com/help-the-book-swag.
BobX3 begins his tweet saying, or I guess his post saying, slow clap. Great job, chat realm. You did it. You broke Diamond Club. Last night during the election, the site couldn't keep up with how many people were watching. Now Sergeant Muffin has to go and spend even more money on the site. You know he does this for free, right? Well, except for whatever like folks like you give them at patreon.com/sergeantmuffin. That's SGTMUFFIN. Are you helping out? You know, lots of other people do stuff for the show free. T2T2 runs the chat realm, chat and showbot. Throw him some nickels and dimes at patreon.com/T2T2. And Tinvec does a ton of behind-the-scenes stuff, like DCTV bot and Diamond Club maintenance. Plus, he added daily tech headlines to the Amazon Echo for you. Toss him some change over at patreon.com/Tinvec. Remember, this doesn't come for free. If you like Diamond Club TV, that's all it's become, or all that it's become, and all that it will be in the future. Thank these guys and show them some love. And you know what? I'm going to add to that. Let's throw patreon.com/spearmintnitrate on there for sure.
Who, of course, does all of our animations.
By the way, my t-shirt has been shipped. Super stoked.
Cool.
Oh, crap. Oh.
Did you get the Diamond Club t-shirt?
I think I did. I don't remember.
That's awesome. I totally bought it just for me. Yeah, sorry.
Oh. You're totally going to get bumps on your shirt.
Bumps?
Bumps?
Bumps? Bumps on a shirt.
Oh.
Bumps on the shirt.
Yeah, that was me just making a bumps and a rup reference.
Got it.
Hey, listen, can we just put into context, like, we made a site, we had this site here a while ago. It was initially set up by Dan Dirks. Sergeant Muffin took it over. It is hard to get 1,000 concurrent viewers to something that is not already a site that has a bunch of other stuff going on.
But now, granted,
diamondclub.tv, of course, is brought in by the chat.
this was an idea that we started because we needed an escape pod to get out from our old network.
Yep.
And the fact that it has flourished into its own town where we could have gigantic events.
Yes, yesterday afternoon.
Like, that's insane.
I got so excited. Yesterday afternoon, I just went to Diamond Club TV and seeing three concurrent streams and being able to click in between. And it was funny because specifically I wanted to know who was talking about the election. I was able to click and then there's Mike TV. Oh, cool. And then I clicked and there's April Ness. And then I clicked and then who else?
Oh, by the way,
it was you.
I think I don't know if we shouted out before, but iOS, it's got its own app. DiamondClub.tv has its own app.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Awesome. That's right. It's pretty cool, and it's only getting better.
Yeah.
It's got the chat built into it. You can pick all the different channels.
Who's responsible for
that? By the way,
I believe that's Sergeant Muffin who
did that. Dude, that's, dude, you know what? That's, that really, truthfully, man.
And T-Vec, who we shouted out earlier, is working on the Android app.
If you are a casual listener, I cannot recommend highly enough that you try dipping your toes into the chat room. This thing is active 24 hours a day. Mm-hmm. It's a community of like-minded individuals. I think you're absolutely going to fall in love with all the wonderful people here. It's really, really great. Consider moving from cocaine to crack. Crack is really great.
Because, yeah, it's great. It's crack. It's a really high. It's a really high. It's great. It's crack. Vincent 404 writes TLDR. He has a video, but I'm just going to read this here while that video plays in the background.
Hey, guys. Roberto Vegas here. And it's...
Take it away. Show him.
Show the video. He's already got it.
Hey, guys. Roberto Vegas here. And it's that time of the year once again. It is time for the Extra Life charity stream. 24 hours of crazy gaming. Guys, it gets a little bit weird and a little bit strange as it goes on through the night. You never know who's gonna show up, what games we're gonna play, or what's gonna happen. So if you'd like to join all the fun, you can join me on November 11th at 8 a.m. Central. You can watch live at twitch.tv/cosmicradiotv. We'll probably play some video games, maybe a little bit of D&D. Who knows what'll happen? Who knows we'll show up? It's all open and totally fun, and it's completely all for charity. And of course, if you want to kick in, help the charity, help the kids, support this, because it's all in good fun, head over to extra-life.org/participant/Vincent404, and don't worry, all those links will be in the description below. Thanks, guys, and I'll see you on November 11th.
Spoiler alert, I'm going to be there on Friday playing D&D.
Oh!
Hey, wait.
Oh, yeah.
So there's...
Yeah!
What do you say we go to the movie draft minute?
Yeah, dude, let's check out the movie draft minute. I hope it sounds totally different like that last guy.
Welcome to your movie draft minute presented by CosmicRadio.tv for the week of November 7th, 2016. I'm your host, Roberto Villegas. Sorry if my heart's not into doing this today.
Roberto.
Bit of a rough night last night. Eventually, I'll be
back. Yeah, did you have all of Twitter calling you?
All right. Turn it down.
No God King.
Let's just get this over with. Milongo AE, Mikey Newman, and Brian Brushwood are all tied for fourth place. Still waiting for their first film. Team DTNS is in third place with Trolls bringing in $49 million this week. Christy Cates is in second place with $49.5 million this week. And in first place with Doctor Strange bringing $91.2 million this week, bringing his total to $117.7 million this week. It's Justin Robert Young. And that is your Movie Draft Minute for the week of November 7th, 2016.
Justin, what you got in the tank for the end of, February? What you got in the February tank?
Jack shit!
Yeah, dude.
Dark Tower got moved. I wound up getting the well-critically lauded La La Land featuring The Gosling and Emma Stone.
Ooh, Rai.
However, I do not think that it will do blockbuster numbers, and I think that even as Doctor Strange seems to have more legs than the average Marvel movie, I think I am cooked.
Yeah, I think we'll know whether or not I have a chance too this very next week. I got Arrival for $11, and it has an outside chance of pulling an Interstellar kind of, you know, Inception level.
It's doing big on Rotten Tomatoes right now.
Right,
it was 100% at some point.
Yeah, the only problem is that it feels. I mean, we're gonna see on which side of like heady side. Like it's either gonna be Contact or Inception.
Yeah. Correct.
And we're going to find out which one it is.
Correct. But meanwhile, like Doctor Strange, you got for $60. I got Arrival for $11. So if it is you know, anywhere in the neighborhood of Doctor Strange, I got a chance at pulling this off. You don't think so?
No.
Yeah, all right. Well, we'll see. But, I mean, I think the de facto winner is going to be DTNS.
I would expect Strange to be the number one movie.
Even with the arrival.
Yeah. I think Marvel has had like out of 11 of the past 14 or something, have been number one movie. So it's some ridiculous number.
Well, no, it was last week. So yeah. It had a huge $80 million opening, $80 plus million opening.
I'm just saying that I think Marvel buys are great buys.
Oh, yeah.
They're always going to open number one, you know?
Can I give a huge shout out to Matt Waffleophagus out in the chat for hooking us up with tickets to the Q&A. Screening and Q&A with the writer of the movie, C. Robert Cargill, your friend of mine. It was amazing. Like, awesome. Watching the movie, and he shows up right at the end because, of course, he hadn't seen, you know, he lives down the street from the village. And so I go running out to see him and immediately give him a hug. I'm like, how have you been, man? And he's just like, you kidding? I made this, and then gestures to the credits rolling behind it. Awesome. It was incredible. It was a great time. It was super, super good. Really enjoyed the movie, and couldn't be more happy for your friend of mine, C. Robert Cargill.
Hey, Puzzle Girls.
Yeah. Hey, there's a whole conversation happening here. This is not a live studio or something.
Yeah. Wait, you didn't.
You have a live mic in your lap, and you guys are just like,
don't worry. I put them on mute because I can hear them.
Welcome to Puzzle Chat.
I love it, Katie.
Look at this one.
Katie's
I wonder
so
how it's
overwhelmed
opening.
By this puzzle box. She's like, all right, hold on. The whole thing has to stop.
I'm sorry.
No, listen. It's just how power the hypnotic draw of the puzzle box. That's the yeah. The Outlaw's Relic, available right now at scamstuff.com.
Smooth and buttery.
Yeah. People can't help but get their hands on that.
We've been handling it all night, and we can't get it open.
Once
it's
secret,
it
is revealed
to you. I wish I could
do
that the whole time. I can't.
Hey,
I didn't wah-pedal.
Hot diggity damn doodle. This was a fuck ton. Oh, good time.
I want to thank everybody, who's in the chat. I mean, again, this is one of those moments where we want to be a community on every level. And I know that we have not agreed politically. Listen, this thing lasted for a million years. We were able to come here today and have a good time. I think we did the episode that we
and
wanted.
And by the way, true heartfelt congratulations. If your guy won, congratulations. That's a rad experience to have, you know? And if you're distraught, you know.
That's okay. It's perfectly normal. Yeah. And at the very least, you can always come here and we can have a good time.
Yeah.
Just give hugs. A couple hours. So the rest of the week can be misery and you come here and you're like, yay!
Yeah.
And you know, of course, because we are all here, we will all hum
our anthem.
Our anthem.
Yeah. Okay, all right, we're going to hum it, though.
Okay. Yeah.
All right, here we go. Hmm.
Yeah.
Oh.
God King.
Ooh, yeah. Dolphins love smarter than America.
Yeah. Allegheny County. Die in a fire.
See you next
Fireman
Tuesday.
Club.
I didn't tweet.
Diamond
Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.